The Renaissance, emerging in Italy during the 14th and 15th century, represented a radical reorientation of artistic vision. Artists sought not only to depict the world, but to understand and reconstruct it according to principles of proportion, harmony, and naturalism. Central to this transformation was the concept of composition, the orchestration of form and space through geometry and perspective. Unlike the more symbolic organization of medieval art, Renaissance composition pursued the measured representation of reality as an expression of divine order. Geometry, once the abstract language of philosophers, became the grammar of visual truth. From Leon Battista Alberti's theoretical treatise to Leonardo da Vinci's pictorial experimentation and Raphael's architectural balance, Renaissance composition was grounded in the belief that art could mirror the rational structure of the cosmos. This video explores how geometry, proportion, and perspective became both scientific tools and spiritual symbols in the art of the Renaissance. The arrival of classical antiquity central to Renaissance humanism redefined artistic goals. Ancient texts such as Vitruvius' De Architectura offered models of proportions rooted in mathematics and the human body. Vitruvius' idea that, quote, without symmetry and proportion, there can be no principles in the designs of any temple, end quote, resonated deeply with Renaissance artists, who equated architectural harmony with universal truth. Humanist philosophy placed humanity at the center of the created order, a reflection of divine rationality. Artists became both observers and interpreters of nature, striving to reconcile sensory experience with intellectual idealism. Geometry thus served as the bridge between the material and the metaphysical. To construct a rationally ordered image was to align art with the divine intellect that governed the universe. No figure was more crucial in articulating the geometry of Renaissance composition than Leon Battista Alberti. His treatise De Pictura of 1435 transformed painting into a mathematical science. Alberti introduced the concept of the visual pyramid, where the viewer's eye serves as the apex and the picture plane as the base. By organizing space according to fixed vanishing points and proportional diminution, artists could produce an illusion of depth consistent with human vision. Alberti's notion of the finestra aperta, the painting as an open window onto the world, defined the new pictorial logic. Composition was no longer arranged hierarchically by theological importance, as in medieval art, but spatially, according to the geometry of sight. The introduction of linear perspective by Filippo Brunelleschi, demonstrated in his architectural studies of Florence, further grounded artistic representation in measurable laws. This system granted art an unprecedented coherence. Objects and figures were positioned within a unified visual field governed by mathematics, echoing the harmony of the cosmos itself. While Alberti provided the theoretical framework, Leonardo da Vinci embodied its empirical and philosophical realization. Leonardo viewed geometry not as abstraction, but as the living structure of reality. His notebooks reveal a relentless fascination with proportion, anatomy, and the geometry of growth. The Vitruvian Man stands as both a scientific diagram and a metaphysical symbol. The human body inscribed within circle and square, the microcosm mirroring the macrocosm. In painting, Leonardo's compositional genius lay in his fusion of mathematical precision and organic flow. Works such as The Last Supper demonstrate perfect perspectival order. The vanishing point converging at Christ's head, yet also subtle rhythm and movement among figures. The geometric center becomes a spiritual one, a rational composition as revelation. Leonardo's writings suggest that perspective was for him not a mechanical device, but an epistemology, a way of knowing the world through proportion and harmony. His blending of sfumato and light geometry further dissolved the boundary between science and art, transforming visual structure into a living experience. If Leonardo embodied the inquiry of the Renaissance mind, Raphael represented its synthesis. His fresco, The School of Athens, in the Vatican's Stanza della Signatura, stands as the apotheosis of compositional order. Constructed upon a rigorous perspectival grid, the painting orchestrates complex philosophical themes through spatial geometry. The central axis unites Plato and Aristotle, framed beneath the arch of classical architecture, a microcosm of intellectual and cosmic harmony. Raphael's mastery lay in translating abstract order into human grace. Every gesture, posture, and gaze aligns with geometric balance. The result is not rigidity, but dynamic equilibrium. The eye moves effortlessly through the pictorial space, guided by invisible mathematical forces. Through Raphael, the Renaissance concept of composition reach its culmination. Geometry as a moral and aesthetic principle to compose well was not merely to organize forms, but to participate in the rational order of creation. The obsession with proportion extended beyond painting to architecture and sculpture. Michelangelo, through often rebelling against classical restraint, remained grounded in the Vitruvian ideal of bodily harmony. His David embodies mathematical ratio as moral virtue, strength expressed through measure. In architecture, Brunelleschi's Spazi Chapel and Alberti's Tempio Malatestiano employed modular systems based on harmonic ratios, translating visual music into stone. Underlying these achievements was a philosophical conviction derived from Neoplatonism. Beauty was a reflection of divine order. Numbers, geometry, and proportion were not human inventions, but manifestations of cosmic truth. Artists, in decoding these principles, became interpreters of the divine mind. This integration of science, philosophy, and aesthetics would shape European art for centuries, even as later movements challenged Renaissance rationalism. The ideal of geometric harmony as the foundation of beauty persisted in artistic theory. Yet the very precision that defined Renaissance art also contained its limitations. As scholars such as Erwin Panofsky observed, perspective was both an achievement and a constraint. A system that equated visual truth with mathematical order, excluding emotional or metaphysical ambiguity. By the 16th century, artists such as El Greco and Tintoretto began to distort perspective to recapture spiritual intensity. The Baroque era that followed would transform rational order into dynamic movement, signaling the end of the Renaissance balance between science and art. Nevertheless, the legacy of Renaissance composition remained indelible. Even in modern abstraction, echoes of its geometry persist. The belief that structure and proportion can reveal something essential about reality itself. The geometry of Renaissance composition was far more than a technical innovation. It was a worldview rendered visible. Through perspective, proportion, and harmonious order, artists sought to reconcile sensory experience with intellectual truth, nature with divinity, science with art. In translating geometry into image, the Renaissance transformed visual representation into a form of philosophy, a reflection of the human mind's capacity to discern order in the cosmos. The hidden geometry behind these works was thus not hidden at all. It was the very essence of what the Renaissance understood as beauty, the visible expression of invisible laws.